Good afternoon, I'm Dr. Shilpa, and I'll be presenting our study on prospective evaluation of greater Anderson's procedure in idiopathic infantile nystagmus. So idiopathic infantile nystagmus is a disorder of unknown etiology. It's characterized by presentation in infancy producing horizontal jerky oscillations of the eye. This usually leads to the adoption of an anomalous head posture so as to increase the visual function because of the presence of an eccentric null zone or the zone in which there is minimal nystagmus intensity. Multiple surgical and non-surgical treatments have been tried for the same. Anderson's procedure is a surgical treatment which involves recession of horizontal yoke muscles. Augmented Anderson's procedure involves large fixed recessions of yoke muscles of the order of 12 mm for lateral rectus and 9 mm for the medial rectus. However, in our study, we have graded the amount of yoke muscle recession individually for each case. We conducted a prospective study over a period of 4 years between January 2014 and December 2017 on a total of 37 subjects, all of whom had idiopathic infantile nystagmus and AHP, and all of whom were above 5 years of age. We have excluded the patients who have undergone prior extraocular muscle surgery, those with cosmetically acceptable AHP, which we considered as being less than 10 degrees, nystagmus secondary to other causes, or those not giving consent for surgery. Among the patients who consented for surgery, the pre-op documentation involved binocular visual acuity in both primary and null position, which was recorded in logMAR for the ease of statistical analysis. Head turn in terms of degree, which was recorded using a goniometer, and the patients underwent surgery under general anesthesia based on the following table. That is, if the initial AHP was 30 degrees, they underwent 12 mm of LR and 9 mm of MR. With 20 to 25 initial AHP, they underwent 11 and 8 millimeters. With 15 degrees, they underwent 10 and 7 millimeters. All of these patients were re-evaluated 1 month after surgery, and changes in visual acuity and AHP were documented. Coming to statistical analysis and results, we analyzed our results using Stata 14.0 software using Wilcoxon signed rank sum test for both vision and AHP. Total of 37 patients were involved in our study, of which 26 were males. The mean age was 12.39 plus or minus 8.64 years, and the range was between 5 and 49 years. Of the total 37 patients, 2 patients also had squint associated with idiopathic infantile nystagmus, and in both patients it was exotropia. The results per se, the visual acuity in logMAR improved from a pre-op mean of 0.47 plus or minus 0.15 to 0.25 plus or minus 0.17. The AHP in degrees improved from 22.5 plus or minus 6.12 degrees to 7.58 plus or minus 3.62 degrees. In both the cases, the results were statistically significant with a p-value of less than 0.001. In both the patients who have undergone strabismus surgery, they underwent MR resection on the non-dominant eye. Following the surgical correction, both patients had satisfactory correction of AHP as well as the squint with the orthoptic status in the fovea range. Coming to discussion, multiple surgical and non-surgical modalities have been tried to alleviate the symptoms of IIN. The non-surgical modalities include prescription of prisms, Botox injections, pharmacological therapy, or use of contact lenses. For the correction of AHP in nystagmus, the surgical correction was first independently suggested by Anderson and Kestenbaum in the year 1953 and by Goto in the year 1954. Anderson postulated that the muscles which are acting in the slow phase of nystagmus overacted and hence advised their recession. Over the years there have been multiple modifications in the original Anderson's procedure, one of which is modified Anderson's procedure, that is retroequatorial recession of yoke muscles, and augmented Anderson's procedure, which is large fixed recession of muscles such as 12 millimeters of LR and 9 millimeters of MR. A study conducted by Jans et al., which was modified Anderson's procedure, that is 2 millimeters retroequatorial recession of horizontal recti muscles in 21 patients, showed that the procedure corrected horizontal, vertical, and torsional components of the initial AHP. Another study similar to ours was a prospective study conducted by Gupta et al., which was the augmented Anderson's procedure, or fixed recessions of 12 millimeters in lateral rectus and 9 millimeters in medial rectus. This was also found to be successful. However, our study differed from the above studies because we had a greater diversity in the amount of initial AHP. That is, it varied between 15 degrees to 30 degrees. So we have titrated the surgical dose based on the initial phase turn, and we have got statistically significant improvement in AHP, as well as good functional and cosmetic results. However, we were not able to get the steropsis recordings in all patients, and we could not document other characteristics of nystagmus, such as intensity and amplitude, because of the lack of ENG recordings. However, in spite of all this, we still wish to say that augmented Anderson's procedure is a good choice of initial surgery in management of AHP, because a fewer number of muscles are being operated to begin with. It deals with recession, which is more physiological and can be reversed if need be. It leaves behind two muscles for further correction in case of residual AHP or other additional surgical procedures. And addition of a grading algorithm to augmented Anderson's procedure is helpful specifically in moderate sized head turns. Thank you.